the drop top with the top down, so you're switching lanes, girl. Pull up to the red light, looking right, come in, let me get your name, girl. Tell me where you're from, what you do, what you like, let me pick your brain, girl. And tell me how they got that pretty little face on that pretty little frame, girl.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the 72nd Paw Print Newscast.
Wow. Next week, Tuesday and Thursday, we will begin Wildcat Prep Days. Drew, can you tell me a little bit more about this?
Well, I've heard from around the block that the days will start at 8:15. Even if you don't have a class registered at 8:15, you must show up, seniors included. The first 2 hours will be for the prep, test prep, so you guys ACT. Yep. Anybody else has got a nice test, they got to come up. Afterwards, we will run a two-hour delay schedule and then dismiss at 3:15 the normal time. Will, you started applying for any scholarships yet?
I have not, actually. Oh, your gum fell.
I've applied for a few, but a great way to get some is volunteering. Have you volunteered at all?
No.
Me neither. Maybe we should probably start doing that.
Okay. Well, St. Rita's volunteering program is starting up here soon. So if you're interested in that, make sure you get all that stuff for that.
Are you going to do that?
Yes, I am. And the deadline is March 9th, and your form should be turned into Mercy Health by 4 p.m.
It's a great way to get some scholarships. Yeah, always volunteer. It's a nice thing for the community to do, too.
40 hours.
Speaking of the community, this Bath community has this week's submissions for the 5th edition of The Fringe.
Students may submit poetry, fiction, nonfiction, and don't forget about the good old art.
Oh, the art.
It all needs to be in by March 29th, though.
It's coming up in about a month.
Yes, and The Fringe will be published this spring, so if anyone has any questions or are interested, make sure you talk to Mr. Seidel.
You guys interested?
I am.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
I'm going to get it.
I'm very artistic. I'm going to look at
it. I think I got it last year.
Isn't it free?
Yes.
I don't know, but I'm looking forward to it.
Look at the cool art and nonfiction and fiction.
And poetry. Poetry's my favorite.
All right. Now let's go listen to some poetry with Mark Lee in his motivational moments.
Meow.
Thanks, Drew. I'm here with Mark Lee, and he's going to give us some motivation today.
This week's motivational moment comes from Stephen Curry. If you don't fall, how are you going to know what it's like to get back up? There you go, Dada. Steph Curry.
Wow. That's amazing. Now it's to Callie and Caitlin with Teacher of the Week. Thanks, Garris. We're here with Teacher of the Week, Mr. McKinney. Now, where did you graduate from high school?
Bath High School.
You're a Bath alumni?
I am. 2008.
That's awesome. Now, where did you go to college?
Well, I originally went to Georgetown College, a small liberal arts college, just north of Lexington, Kentucky, for 2 years. And then I transferred to Bluffton University for my final 2 years. Go Beavers.
Nice. What year did you graduate from Bluffton?
Oh, wow. 2012.
I was only 12 years old. What made you decide to teach social studies?
I am not smart enough to teach math or science. English is blah. So I settled on social studies.
All right. That's awesome. So, what class is your favorite one to teach out of the classes that you do teach?
Fourth period American history is so much fun.
So, that's your favorite?
Well, I mean, in general, like, American history is my favorite class to teach. But fourth period, well, we're not supposed to have favorites, are we?
No.
Okay, well, maybe they're not my favorite then.
All right, well, okay, last question. What's something out of all the pet peeves that you have that just really grinds your gears because you're really passionate about everything?
All right, so this is a big deal for, you know, newly married, so this is a really big deal in our household. My wife doesn't know the distinction between the 8 million different kinds of apples, and I really don't like Red Delicious apples, so she bought Red Delicious apples like on multiple occasions when I really wanted Honeycrisp apples. So That really, 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 really grinds my gears. But we're working on it. It's a process.
Wow, that would really make me mad, too.
Yeah. Especially when you want a Honeycrisp.
Yes, and marriage is all about growing.
It is.
Yes.
It is.
Now back to the studio for sports.
You currently are.
Boys basketball regular season came to an end with a close game with Ken, but they lost 62-57.
Well, Caden, let's travel on the opposite end of the spectrum here. Well, girls basketball season ended the sectional tournament versus St. Mary's, but fell short, 45-36. I think that's a pretty decent way of concluding the season, wouldn't you think?
I guess so.
All right.
And with our some boys basketball, Chad Fry did end up earning first team All-WBL, and Harrison did get honorable mention. Good job, boys.
Are we going to the opposite side of the spectrum once again? Jaden Hill got first team, Lindsay Singhouse earned second team, and Bette Andrews earned honorable mention.
All right, now let's move on to some very interesting news from the postseason. We have Colin Mell, who's going to represent Bath at districts in wrestling. So, do you gentlemen and women believe that we have a potential state
Vincent
wrestler?
Abrams, I will bet my first child's kidney that Colin Mell will go to state in wrestling.
Well, I bet my child's pancreas that Colin Mell is going to be a state athlete.
That's a risky one.
Well, anyways, we're going to go out to our Bree Twining interview about her becoming a state bowler.
In only the second season, the Bath girls bowling team has had much success, and this season, senior Bree Twining has qualified for the state bowling meet in Columbus.
Pretty confident, and I was hoping for the best for the team and myself, and I was hoping to go far. So far, that's what we did, and I'm hoping to do good and get far in state.
Bree acknowledges that most of her motivation comes from family and spending a lot of time at the bowling alley as a child.
My motivation was probably my dad pushing me. He always believed in me and my bowling and always came out, practiced with me, and always kept me calm going into matches and tournaments and everything. So I grew up at Northland. We pretty much lived there growing up. And so we pretty much grew up there. I bowled all the time when I was younger.
Bree has had a lot of success and has achieved great scores.
My highest score this season bowling was a 257, and I think that was about halfway through the season. But my high game was when we were just out practicing for fun last year, and that was a 290.
Bree admits that Bath's bowling team has been a great experience for her.
So far it's been fun. It was kind of bumpy getting people out, and so especially me and my friends that grew up bowling, we tried to go in and recruit friends that we would have fun with and that we think would have potential in bowling. And so we had fun as a team together and just grew more as a team and friendships too.
Well, being our only second year of bowling as a sport at Bath, the first year we didn't really know what kind of accomplishments we would have. It was kind of a brand new thing for all of us, the bowlers and myself. And Bree had a wonderful year last year and ended up being bowler of the year in the WBL. So that being on her back was something that she, I think, had a lot of pressure to show in her second year that she was still capable of doing. Bree is a very quiet girl, and in her first year, I think she didn't know the other girls as well, and so she wasn't as much of a leader in her first year. She led by her actions on the lanes. She was a very good bowler, but as far as helping the others, she was very quiet. I saw that come out differently in the second year. She really took a leadership role on the team and helped some of the other bowlers and showed by not only her actions on the lanes but off the lanes what she could do for our team and how they should act on the lanes and also help them in their games on the lanes.
I think just going out with friends and having fun, just working on your game, you know, there's always potential to getting better. And it's not really, you don't have to be so competitive, it's fun, just have fun with your friends, and the more fun you have, the better you guys will tend to be.
Good luck to Bree Twining this weekend at the State Bowling Meet in Columbus.
Congratulations, Bree. Now we're all wishing you the best of luck at State. Anyways, now we're out with the weather. Sean and Connor. You must not know about me. I could have
another you in a minute. Matter of fact, he'll be here in a minute. Thanks, Vincent. Connor, tell me what's going on Friday.
Well, Friday, it's going to be a little windy with a high of 44 and a low of 28. What is Saturday looking like?
Saturday's going to be sunny with a high of 44 and a low of 27. How about for that church day?
Well, on church day, it's going to be a high of 46 and a low of 32. But it's going to be sunny, so it may be warmer. Who knows?
Thank you for your input. Now, let's go out to the halls for some games.
Alright, I'm here with Sarah and we're going to play Just Dance. Are you ready?
I'm ready, Freddy.
Okay, take position.
Hello guys, we are here with the grooviest junior, Stephen Parthamore. Now Stephen, can you get jiggy with it?
Oh heck yeah.
Alright, let's do it. I say that was the grooviest thing I've seen all day. Hello guys, we're here with an even funkier junior, Hollis Erickson. Hollis, you think you can give me some solid dance moves?
Yeah, I think I can.
All right, let's get into this.
Yeah, very little.
Beautiful.
I'm here with Maddie, and I'm going to play a song, and she's going to dance to it, okay?
All right.
I love it.
I'm here with Hunter, and Hunter, do you think you can dance?
Nope.
Any good moves?
No.
Can you show us some?
I guess. Woman is my destiny, she said. Shout out to Betty Destiny. That's all I got.
Pretty solid dance moves.
I thought you were spazzing.
All right, I'm here with Alex Davis, and we're going to play Just Dance, okay?
All right.
I'm going to play a song for you. You dance however you want.
What you do with this?
I'm here with Miss You, and Miss You, are you ready to dance?
Sure.
All right, let's dance. Thank you.
I'm Christina, and I'm going to play for a song for you, and you're going to dance to it, okay?
Okay.
Exactly how I would dance to that song.
We're here with Caitlin Rabel, and we're going to play Just Dance. We're going to play a song for you, and you're going to do a dance to it, okay?
You guys right. Doing it with me, right?
Yes, okay. Of course. Okay. We're all in this together. Sweet. It's not High School Musical. Okay. We're flying up no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that gazole in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body. It drops. Ooh. Thank you, guys.
In need of a photographer?
Richard Parrish is the man for the job. He does weddings, senior pictures, parties, anything you need, give him a call today at 419-371-1959. I'm here with photographer Richard Parrish, and I have a few questions for you today.
Okay.
So, what events do you take photos at?
Mostly high school. Is primarily mostly high school. I mean, I do other things. I do weddings. I do events. But majority of my work is done in high school sports. Mm-hmm.
And I've seen you at quite a few events, and I've got some photos from you, actually. So, if you want to purchase those, where do you go for that?
They're on my online website, which is www.hburst.net.
And we'll have that in the link, so check that out. And what got you into photography?
My father did, because when I was little, I used to see him carry a camera, a Polaroid, you know, a little...
Yeah, yeah. Little,
take a picture, come out. Well, ever since I was little, I just, like, man, I want to do what he did. You mm-hmm. know? So that's what really got me into it.
Yeah, all the way from the beginning. Yeah. Those little Polaroids are cute, yeah. too. Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
With Student of the Week, McKenna McChicken Hale. Kenna, how do you like high school so far?
It's been pretty tough, but I'm getting through it.
Me too.
What's your favorite color?
I'd have to say pink.
And do you have any siblings?
Yes, I have two, Jaden and Brady.
And what grade are they in?
Jaden's a senior and Brady's in sixth grade.
And what sports do you do?
I play soccer, basketball, and I'm doing track this year.
Are you really fast?
I'm all right.
And what's your favorite food?
Anything that comes from a potato, like French fries and stuff like that.
I like that too. All right, Student of the Week, McChicken.
Okay, I need an assistant.
Oh boy,
anybody?
Oh boy, me.
You, get up here. All right, now I'm gonna make him disappear. 3, 2, 1. Ta-da!
What are you doing?
Oh, I'm just practicing for the talent show on Friday, April 13th at 7 p.m.
Do I have to audition? When do I do that?
You can sign up anytime before March 16th during your Wildcat time or lunch.
And if you didn't catch that, this is a fundraiser for prom, so please, if you want to have a good prom, I beg you to spend your money and come. Oh, 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 it's magic, you know.
Never believe it's not so.
There's a story all about take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some meatball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared. And uncle in Bel-Air. I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase to send me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said I might as well kick it. First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of a champagne glass. Is this what the people of Bel-Air live like? This might be alright. I whistled for a cab and when it came near, the license plate said fresh in a dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, man, forget it. Yo, home to Bel-Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8 and I yelled to the cabbie, yo, home, smell you later. Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel-Air.
Hamburg pickle on top makes your heart go flippity flop.
Have you had your QP today?
Here's the thing, we started out friends. It was cool, but it was all pretend. Yeah, yeah.
Before we conclude the 22nd edition of the Paw Print Newscast, we have a few more announcements. Connor, what's the first one?
This past Monday, our very own band and choir had their concert contest. The concert choir, chamber choir, jazz band, concert band, and symphony band performed. That's
a lot of songs, lots of bands.
Long time.
Sounds fun.
The Lima Locos are having tryouts to sing the national anthem at the games this summer. If you are interested, tryouts are being held on April 28th.
You know, I've been told at basketball games that I have a pretty nice falsetto for the national
anthem. You really do. I've listened.
I like it.
It's pretty good.
Took about 18 years to perfect that.
Yeah.
The Locos are also looking for a Larry the Loco, which is their team mascot. So anyone interested in either that or this, please contact the 2016 Bath alumni, Alex Schrader. I miss Alex.
Me too.
Taylor Swift
especially
fanatic.
She was, dude. She was a Taylor Swift part two. Hey, Alex. Do it every time.
This week's another drawing for a $10 gift card. Let's go out to our editors for the Paw Print newspaper now.
This week's drawing is for a $10 Chipotle gift card.
Jackson Chim, congratulations. Make sure to tune in on April 6th for the next drawing.
Student Council is holding a talent show on April 13th at 7 p.m. in the high school auditorium. Sign-ups are available now until March 16th. Auditions will be held March 27th and 28th.
Did you guys see Will's audition for it?
No, I'm not.
He's going in as a magician. He made Caden disappear.
Wow.
It was pretty cool.
Was it cool?
Yeah, it was some good video editing. I don't think it was really real, but...
Oh. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's
Are you
going
to be in it?
I'm not. I don't have any talents.
I don't either.
Any talents I could win. I got some weird talents.
Like what?
I could pop my belly button inside out.
That is weird.
Weird talents always win, though.
Good point.
Yeah, like the dude off of AGT who, like, swallowed stuff. Remember that guy?
Yeah.
They were your agitator. No, I won't be doing it. But if I were to do it, I'd probably sing a song. Guess what song that would be?
What would that be?
1,000 Miles. Off of White, is it White Chicks?
Yep.
White Chicks.
They go, na 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 na.
And I need you.
Na 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 na.
And I miss you.
We have a music video about that, actually. Almost as good as what we just did there, but let's watch that.
Tonight.
Making my way downtown, walking fast, faces pass and I'm homebound.
Such a good song.
We want to remind everyone of safe driving with a tip from Jack and Kay from Always Right Driving School. Drew, what is that tip?
Always pull off the side of the road when emergency vehicles are approaching.
Always remember that.
Very good quote. It's really true. And that concludes this edition of the Paw Print Newscast, and we hope you have a fantastic weekend.
Now let's roll out to some credits.
Tomorrow is the makeup ACT here at Bath, so good luck to those test takers. Now, Emily, tell me about pennies for patients.
Stop. Okay, I'm sorry.
You're a hairy wizard.
Let's get this road on the show.
Road on the show. We should just do the whole, welcome to the 21st
welcome to the
PPNC of edition.
Welcome to the cast news.
Shut up. That's not who I meant to hit.
Man down.
Monday, the February 26th.
Nothing as of now.
How about would you like to?
You could do so much. You could do anything.